Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, I want to go over the offset function, but with a particular application when you are trying to import data and it comes in only in the form of one column. We covered this a little bit a couple weeks ago when we imported a PDF, but I want to go into a lot of detail on how this works because we are going to be starting a data series where we're going to be importing data into Excel from a lot of external sources. So sometimes this scenario may happen to you and it would be good to know ahead of time that it's perfectly fine if your data doesn't come in the way that you want it and there is a quick way to be able to go and format it so it looks like a table. Because we're hoping to use a dynamic offset function where the number that we are going down changes based on the data that we are trying to retrieve, we are also going to use the columns function and the rows function today. So in total, you are going to learn three functions: offset, columns, and rows. So here's an example of a PDF that I have imported and how the information only went into one singular column. Do you see that on the left side of the screen? I have a record that starts with the date, but if I look over here, my next record that starts with the date is down about 7 rows, and then the one after that is down about 7 rows. So my data does not look very useful in this kind of manner. What I would like to do is transform my data in this singular column into 7 different columns so that my data will become more useful. So if you look over here, you will see that my data is coming in as a date in the first row, and then I don't get another date until I'm in the 8th row. What I would like to do is take each one of those dates and put them into a singular column right here. And then if I take the next cell, say cell A2, and then I go 7 columns down after that, and I go to cell A9. Those are the values I would like to have in column D, and so on. So how are we going to accomplish this? So I created a spreadsheet to show you the inner workings of the functions that we're going to be using today. The first function that we're going to use is the offset function. The offset function takes 3 arguments, plus 2 optional arguments. But today we are only going to work with the first 3 arguments. The first argument is a reference cell. Where does our entire data set start? So in our case, it's always going to start here on A1 because that's the beginning of my data set. Then my next question is, how many rows do I want to go down? And a positive number will mean I'm moving downwards, and a negative number will mean I'm moving upwards. The third argument is how many columns do I go over? So a positive number will take you one column to the right, and a negative number will take you a column to the left. But in our case, we are only going to be in this one column. So first, let's create this table manually. How do we go about doing that? Well, I've already started to do that from column K to column Q, but let's look at the formula that I have in there. I am using just the plain offset formula, and this is pretty simple to read. So my first argument is asking for what is my reference cell, and all of my data starts on cell A1, and I want to move down 0 and then over 0. So I'm getting my first piece of data in this column. If I move to the next column, you will see that I'm moving down 1 and over 0. And then my next column, I want to move down 2, and my next column 3, 4, 5, 6. So this captures this data over here. That is my first record. So for my 7th one, I'm going to click on K2, and you will see that I'm moving down now 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And as you can imagine, if I click here, I'm going to move down 14. So if you look at K1, you will see that I'm moving down 0, but if you look at K2, you will see I'm moving down 7. I want you to think of this number 7 here as 7 times the number of rows beyond the original that I am on. So this is my first new row beyond the original. So this is actually 7 times 1 plus whatever I have in the column that I'm on, which is the 0. And this is correct because 7 times 1 plus 0 is 7, which is the 7th cell down over here, which is the number that I want. Now let's look here. I am down 8, which is really 7 times 1 plus, if I go back to L1, this one right here. So that's 8. So if I go move down 8 from this cell here, I am actually on the 8th move down from my original cell. Same thing over here, 9 and 2, 10 and 3, 11 and 4. So you can see I'm incrementing by 7. So if I were to go here, I would do offset and I would do A1, comma, 14, comma, 0. Close my parentheses. process and hit enter. And I'm also being returned with, this will be my third one down. So 14, so you could think of this as 7 times 2 because I'm on my second new row beyond the original, plus this 0. So that's the formula that I'm trying to get in here when I'm manually building this. I made a little matrix over here to show you some of those numbers. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So how do I know what column I'm on right here? Well, I can use a function called the columns function. If I go over here, I want to return how many columns are between A1 and A1, or A1 and B1, or A1 and C1, A1 and D1. And you can see these are all incrementing by 1 up until I get to my 7th column out here. But if you look over here, I really want these numbers to be moving 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6. So I really want them moving 1 less than what's here. So if I go up here and I'm going to use the offset formula, I'm going to type equals offset with a left parenthesis, and I want to start with A1, but I'm going to always want to start with A1. So I'm going to click in front of the A and hit function F4, if you remember that from our shortcut video. And that's the reference I will always start at. Then I'm going to type a comma, and now I'm being asked how many rows do I want to go down in my data set. Well, I'm going to use the columns function, and I'm going to start with the column that I'm on, and I'm going to lock the first column that I'm on. But remember, that number of columns, I want to subtract 1 because I don't want to return a 1. I want to return a 0 in this case. And then I'm going to type a comma, going back to my offset formula, and I'm going to type a 0 because I want to move over 0 columns. I'm going to end the parentheses and hit enter. So you can see this right here that I am being returned with the right date. If I drag my data over, I'm going to have a formatting issue because right here, these are going to come out as a date, and I really want them to be a number, so I'm just going to fix that. And you can see that if I type over here, I'm going from column S to V. How many columns is that? S-T-U-V, that's 4, minus 1 will give me 3. So I'm going to move down 3 and over 0. So if I come over here and I move down 3 and over 0, I'm at 1,000, so these numbers do match. But what if I want to move this formula down to the next row? I'm going to delete this so that you can see what happens. I'm returned with the same data, and that's because I've only accounted for my columns. I have not accounted for my rows. And remember, when I move down my row, it is the first row that I'm on beyond the original times 7. So when I click over here, I have some calculations on what row I'm on. In this case, I'm starting on row 1, but down here I'm starting on row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, so that's why I'm being returned with this number. But remember, again, I want to subtract 1 from that because it's the first row beyond my original, and then I want to multiply it by 7 because that's how many columns I have. So let's do that. I'm going to click in this cell and I'm going to add rows with a left parenthesis, and I'm going to go from row 1 to row 1, and I want to put a dollar sign in front of my first row because I want to lock that down. I'm going to close my parentheses, and then I'm going to subtract 1 because I want to take it down to 1 less than it was, and I'm going to put my entire rows argument into parentheses including the minus 1, and I'm going to multiply by 7 and hit enter. Now I'm going to drag that formula down, and you can see that the dates actually are changing this time. So if I go to this one down here, you can see that my columns, I have 1 minus 1, that's a 0, but now my rows from row 1 to 5 is 5 rows, minus 1 is 4 rows, times 7 is 28. But remember, when I'm doing the offset, I'm moving down 28 spots, so I'll be in cell 29. So what do I have in cell 29? 7-2, and that's exactly where this number is coming from. So if I highlight this column and I drag over to the right, and again, I have to reformat these cells into a number because it drags the date format along with it, you will see that my data has been updated. So let's just spot check a few. If I go into here, if I go into V2, you will see 250. So let's do the calculation. My offset is going to be STUV, which is 4 columns, minus 1, which is 3. So remember the 3 for the column argument, plus 2 rows, minus 1, which is 1 row, times 7. So that's going to be 7 plus 3, which will be 10, but I'm moving down 10, so what's in cell 11? And you will see 250. So let's spot check another one. In this case, I have column S to T minus 1. So S to T is 2 columns, minus 1 is 1, plus rows 1 to 4, which is 4, minus 1, which is 3, times 7, which is 21, plus 1, which is 22. But remember, I'm moving down 22, so I'm actually looking in row 23, and you see Jim, and it matches Jim right here. So this has calculated correctly, and I've quickly moved my one column of data into 7 columns of data just using the offset function. So in summary today, we use the offset formula with the columns argument and the rows argument to help organize our data from one column into a set number of columns in a table. Next week, we're going to begin a data series on how to import data from other Excel workbooks as well as other data sources. So please check back next week if you're interested in that. Hopefully you learned something new today, and see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.